Charger Lab has done multiple charging tests on the Ugreen 300 watts Nexode 5-in-1 charger. As a multi-port charger, its USB-C 1 will not be affected under any circumstances, and it can even support a total charging power of 300 watts in such a small size. To know how it works, we're going to take it apart to see its internal components. We'll briefly introduce the appearance. You can click the upper right corner to check the review of this charger for more details. The Ugreen logo and the charger appearance are printed on the black box. Let's open the box. The input end adopts a three-prong design for grounding. All the specs info above the input socket, but list CD333. It has four black USB-C ports and a purple USB-A port on the front. The size is about 112x93x53mm. And the weight is about 850 grams. Next, let's start to take it apart. Remove the anti-slip strip. The button cover is fixed with two screws. Use a spudger and hammer to remove the input cover. And it is fixed with clips. Take out the PCB module. There are pink thermal pad pasted inside the case for heat dissipation. The PCB module is fixed by heat-resistant tape. It is also wrapped and insulated by copper sheets and mylar sheets, and the copper sheets are fixed by soldering. The internal components are covered by thermal pads and copper sheets for heat dissipation. Remove the thermal pad and cover sheet. There are a fuse, safety extra capacitor, thermistor, common mode choke, capacitor, and transformers on the front. There are MOSFETs and controllers on the back. The white dotted areas separate the primary and secondary sides. Charger Lab found it adopts a PFC circuit and LDLC topology with fixed output voltage. And it also adopts the optocoupler for output voltage feedback. Next, we'll take a look at each component, starting from the input end. The time delay fuse is from Conker MST series, 250 volts, 5 amp. The NTC thermistor is wrapped in heat shrinkable tubing. Here is the yellow safety extra capacitor. The common mode choke is wound with magnet and insulated wires. Another safety extra capacitor is under the common mode choke, 0.47 microfarad. The blue-white capacitor is soldered here. The second common mode choke is wound with flat copper wires and is insulated with a frame. Two bridge rectifiers for the power supply are connected in parallel. They are placed on both sides of the copper sheet for heat dissipation. The film capacitors are from Nitei, 1 microfarad, 450 volts. The filter inductor is wound with a magnet core and is insulated with tape. Move to the primary side. The primary MOS control chip is from NXP. It is a digital configurable combo controller for LLC and PFC, and is suitable for high-efficiency resonant power supplies. These two electrolyte capacitors are used to power the MOS control chip. Next is the PFC circuit. Two PFC boost MOSFETs are from Navitas, and they adopt QFN 6x8 package. They are connected in parallel. They integrate GaN FET, GaN driver, and logic circuit. 650 volts, 70 milliohm. These two resistors are connected in parallel and used to detect the current of PFC circuit, 65 milliohm. Here is another NTC thermistor. The PFC boost inductor is wound with ATQ31 magnetic core, and the magnetic core is insulated by copper foil. The PFC boost rectifier is from Global Power Technology and is actually a silicon carbide diode. It adopts a DFN 8x8 package, 650 volts, 8 amp. Those two electrolytic capacitors for input filtering are from Econ, 450 volts, 100 microfarad. And these four MLCC capacitors are connected in parallel with the electrolytic capacitors. These two LLC MOSFETs are from Infineon Coolmos series and can form half bridge. They adopt PG-VSON-4 package, 650 volts, 125 milliohm. The resonant inductor is wound with ATQ23 magnetic core. The resonant capacitor is from Ferrotronic, 0.047 microfarad, 630 volts. The thermistor attached to the transformer is used to detect the temperature and protection. The LLC transformer is wound with ATQ27 magnetic core and is insulated by copper foil and the plastic case. Two optocouplers are from Everlight. They're used for output voltage feedback and protection. The dual LLC synchronous rectifier controller is also from NXP. It can support voltage of 38 volts, far beyond the 28 volts output requirement of USB PD 3.1, and it integrates two independent synchronous rectification drivers. These two synchronous rectifiers are from Infineon, 100 volts, 3.6 milliohm. These four solid capacitors for output filtering are from Polycap RV series, 680 microfarad, 35 volts. The output filtering inductor is wound with magnet wires. This small PCB at the output end is used for secondary buck conversion. There are four USB-C and a USB-A sockets on it. Each port has its own buck inductor and solid capacitors. Flip to the back, we can see some buck controllers, MOSFETs, and VBUS MOSFETs. It has 5 buck circuits in total, starting with the circuit of USB-C1. The buck controller is from iSmartware. It is a highly integrated multi-protocol dual-port charging SoC that supports charging of any USB-C and USB-A ports. These two synchronous buck MOSFETs are from RuiChips and adopt PDFN3333 package, 40 volts, 8 milliohm. The buck inductor is wrapped in red heat shrinkable tubing. The solid capacitors are from Polycap RN series, 100 microfarad, 35 volts. Here is one of the VBUS MOSFET. Next, here are two circuits of USB-C2 and USB-C3. The buck controller is also from iSmartware. It is used for protocol identification. There are two synchronous buck MOSFETs. The buck inductor for USB-C2 is wrapped in black heat shrinkable tubing. These solid capacitors are all from Polycap RN series. There are 100 microfarad 35 volts and 220 microfarad 25 volts respectively. The VBUS MOSFET is from NCE, 30 volts 1.9 milliohm. Lastly, let's take a look at two circuits of USB-C4 and USB-A. The buck controller of USB-C4 is also from iSmartware. It integrates a 3.5 amp synchronous rectifier buck converter and supports multiple charging protocols. The buck controller for USB-A is the same as that of USB-C4. The USB-C sockets are black, the USB-A socket is purple, and it has widened pin to support high current fast charging. Well, those are all components of this Ugreen 300W 5-in-1 charger. Its maximum charging power is 300W, and the USB-C1 supports 140W PD 3.1. After taking apart, there are many copper sheets and thermal pad inside for heat dissipation. It adopts a highly integrated 2-in-1 controller from NXP for PFC and LLC control. That's why it can output 300 watts and control the temperature under normal range. Each port has its own independent buck circuit. All the ports will not be disturbed by others when you charge multiple devices at the same time. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!